In this set of, or in this part of the MOOC, we're going to discuss the endocrine system. So the endocrine system is very important in maintaining homeostasis. And homeostasis is, by definition, the maintenance of a dynamically stable state. So you are dynamically stable. You're not static in that you're not frozen in time and all of your systems aren't frozen. You're dynamic in that you're changing from moment to moment, but overall, you're stable. Your blood pressure isn't going way up or way down. Your temperature's not going way up and way down. So that's what we're talking about when we're talking about homeostasis, dynamically stable state. In the NeuroMOOC, if you looked at that, we talked about the autonomic nervous system and how it is part of your nervous system and it contributes to homeostasis. In this MOOC, we're going to speak about the endocrine system, and the endocrine system is slow. It doesn't work very fast at all because it's humoral, i.e. blood-borne. So endocrine system is hormones. They're secreted into your blood supply that takes those hormones to other parts of your body where then they act on those cells and then those cells respond. And so it has an effect on your internal environment, but it is definitely not fast. It is slow. So there are several different types of secretion when we're talking about the whole body and the endocrine system specifically. So you have exocrine secretion, and exocrine is systems with ducts. So your salivary glands, sweat glands, little glands that make a product like saliva or sweat, secrete it into a duct, and then that duct leads to the surface of your skin or the lumen of your gut or something like that. We have autocrine secretion, which is when a single cell makes a product that it secretes into its surround, and then that comes back and binds on that cell, that same cell. We have paracrine secretion, and paracrine means nearby or local. And so cells will secrete a peptide or a hormone that will then act on cells nearby the cell that created the substance. And then, of course, we have endocrine. Now, endocrine is then no ducts. It secretes into the vasculature, and those products or hormones are going to act at a distance. So here's my little drawings of autocrine. We have a cell at the top that is the little red diamonds are the secretory product. The cell secretes it. It comes back around, binds to a receptor on that same cell. So auto, meaning self, it drives. The peptide comes out and binds to the same cell that made it. Paracrine, again, acting locally. So the little green cells are making some sort of a peptide or hormone, and it's secreted and it binds to the little blue cells on their receptors, so it's a local interaction. Exocrine, again, are things that secrete into ducts. So you'll have some sort of a cuboidal epithelium that's been modified to create a secretory product. And some of the best examples, easiest ones to talk about, are salivary glands that create saliva. And obviously they have ducts that secrete into your oral cavity. Sweat glands secrete via a duct onto the surface of your skin, help you to sweat and help reduce your body temperature. The exocrine pancreas that is reviewed in this part of the MOOC within the GI system, the digestive enzymes of the pancreas are also secreted into ducts that then dump into your duodenum. And your liver is another part of your GI system that makes bile and secretes that into the GI system via a system of ducts. The endocrine system, endocrine glands, consist of a cuboidal epithelium that's kind of, you know, in these cells, that secretes into capillaries. So endocrine glands have tons and tons of capillaries within them. They secrete into these capillaries, which is kind of labeled here. This is a capillary. And they have what are called fenestra. They're fenestrated capillaries, which means little windows that make them more open so that the hormones can get in. And then these capillary beds, of course, are going to join the greater vascular system that you learned about in Dr. Fox's MOOC on the cardiovascular system. And then the vascular system distributes those hormone products throughout the entire body. But then they only bind where is appropriate. But they do go absolutely everywhere. Hormones can either be proteins or small peptides. That usually will then bind somewhere in the body to a surface receptor. And we have steroid hormones. When you think of steroid hormones, you're thinking about the sex steroids, testosterone, estrogen, progesterone, that we'll talk about later. These act via nuclear receptors, so they go into the cell and bind to a receptor that's already in the nucleus. So to summarize, I know this was kind of a lot of information for the first introduction, but what I want you to know and what will get you ready for the assessment is, what are the different types of secretion? So think ducts, no ducts. Think about the individual cell and whether it's local or at a distance. Then what are the big differences between exocrine glands and endocrine glands? And be able to define homeostasis. Once you have all of these concepts in your head, you're going to be ready for the assessment.